Hello, everyone. My name is...
Can't hear you. Speak up.
Hello, everyone. I'm going to recite a poem for you all today. I wrote it on my own, so it's not very nice. You tell me if you like it. I can't remember the first line. If you're worried that that's going to be you every time you get in front of an audience, or if you're just someone who wants to improve their public speaking skills, then this video is for you. Now, I believe that if you want to improve something, you need to figure out why you're bad at it in the first place. So let's dive into the why part of the whole thing. Number one, you can't laugh at yourself, so you worry that everyone else is laughing at you. Look at the nightmare that I just portrayed right now. So instead of freezing on stage when you mess up, all you have to do is laugh at your own self. It's not a life for that situation. Just be on stage and tell the audience, "I'm sorry, I really had rehearsed this part like 10 times, but look at me, my nerves are getting the best of me." And laugh at yourself. And you know what? 99% of the time, the audience is going to laugh with you. And the minute you do that, the audience is in your pocket. They're on your side. So you don't have to worry about that anymore. Just don't take it so seriously. Learn to laugh at yourself. It's okay. Number two, and this is a good one. You have become an expert at the blame game. You get off the stage and maybe because you were so nervous, you made a few blunders here and there. But instead of, like the first step, laughing at yourself or just owning up to them and being relaxed about it, you start blaming everything around you. Have you heard this saying called, "Nach na jaane angan teda"? Yeah. So it's about blaming everything around you for your own mistakes. So the next time if you find yourself saying, the lighting was just not good enough, the mic was too loud, there was that one person in the audience who was constantly texting so I couldn't focus, I was distracted, I just didn't sleep well last night, I did not get my beauty sleep, so you know, I was a bit conscious of myself. I don't know why I'm talking in this accent. What was I talking about? Remember that good speakers emerge from trial and error practices, methods, all those good things. But they do not emerge from the blame game. So if you're making these excuses, you need to reevaluate. Mistakes are just part and parcel of the entire process of getting good at public speaking. It does take some time and effort. But if you keep blaming small things around you, you're never going to make yourself accountable for it. So you're never going to look at yourself and say, "Oh, maybe I wasn't so good at this point. Maybe next time I should focus on improving this part of the delivery. Or maybe I'm stumbling because I cannot say this one word correctly. So maybe next time I'll just avoid it." So it's important to honestly review yourself so that you can better yourself. But if you keep blaming everything around you, are you really taking responsibility for how you're performing? Mostly not, right? So ditch the blame game today. Number three, you picture the worst case scenario. We all have this horrible habit of picturing the worst case scenario of anything scary that we're about to try. So you're going for an interview, you're going to start visualizing, "Oh, I'm going to tank it and I'm never going to get selected. I just don't have the qualities." Similarly, about public speaking, like the dream that we just saw, or let me call it a nightmare, we all have this habit of picturing such horrible things happening that we actually scare ourselves so much It's almost like a self-fulfilling prophecy. So I'm not saying just because you visualize it going bad, it's going to go bad, but you're sort of conditioning your mind to think that I'm not gonna be good at this. And then when you go on stage or for an interview or any situation that pops in your head right now, you are sort of pulling yourself away from a confident self that you deserve to be. So now this is where you need to start visualizing the best case scenario. If you're going on stage, you're going to be like, oh, I have my script. I think it's gonna be good. People are going to laugh at my jokes. They're gonna have a good time. I'm going to have a good time. And then by the end of it, everyone's going to appreciate the effort that I put into it. And I challenged myself to step out of my comfort zone. Now, just because you visualized it again, it's not going to automatically turn out the way you pictured it in your head. But what it's essentially doing is it's giving you the confidence to trust yourself enough to put your best foot forward and give it your best shot. Number four, you're only focusing on the content and not the performance. Believe it or not, the most important part of public speaking is not just what you're speaking, but how you're speaking. Your delivery, your performance matters more. But what happens most of the times, we're going to spend hours and hours scripting out the perfect speech, the perfect joke, the perfect whatever it may be. But what happens is we forget to practice how to perform. What I mean by this is, when you have your script in front of you, you need to go word by word, sentence by sentence, and underline, have different keys, like different colors for different things, and underline and write down, oh, this is where I'm going to talk really fast to create an effect. This is where I'm going to take a dramatic pause. This is where I'm going to hold for applause. Or this is where I'm going to bow down. Or this is where I'm going to use my hand gestures to act like I'm talking on the phone. You need to plan out your performance and not just your content or your script. Because you might have it in your head, but when you actually go on stage, you might very quickly forget that because that's when the nerves hit. So your content is important, definitely, but your delivery or your performance has to be A1. And lastly, number five, you are practicing incorrectly. You heard me right. I'm sure you'll be able to relate to this scenario. You have your script, you start reading it, okay? You have it in your head, you're picturing it, you're actually just, you can hear your own voice, you can hear how it's going to sound on stage, right? And you're like, wow, this really sounds fun, I'm gonna rock the stage, you know what? I'm so excited for this. Fine, all good. The day comes, you go on stage, and then you say it, but guess what? It doesn't sound the way you pictured it in your head. Why, you ask? Because you never actually practiced it. It's really important to speak out when you're practicing. Practicing just in your head just doesn't cut it. You need to read it out loud a few times in the way that you want to perform. Then you need to stand in front of a mirror and perform it with the right body language, with the right facial expressions, with the right hand gestures, with the right voice modulation. You need to see yourself do that. Then you need to switch on your video camera and you need to record yourself, and then you need to watch it, analyze it, make corrections. Maybe, oh, you're like, oh, this is not sounding as good as I thought it would. You need to go back to your paper, make that change, and repeat all the steps all over again. Yes, it does take a lot of hard work, but just saying it in your head, practicing it in your head, is not going to give the effect that you want it to give. Maybe a long way down the line, when you've become so good at it that you can skip these other steps, maybe then you won't require it, but till then, you absolutely need to practice the correct way. Otherwise, you'll just say, oh, I read it for an hour in my head and it still came out wrong. So that's not the right way of doing it, right? So there you have it. A few steps that you need to change, a few things that you need to eliminate. Do that. You figured out why you may not be so good at it or what's stopping your progress. Now that you eliminate these few things, the road is wide open and clear in front of you. Don't forget to check the website link that I've put in the description box. It's a link to my website for my startup called ClassApart, where I groom students and corporates in spoken English, confidence building, public speaking, personality development, so on and so forth. So if you are interested in topics like this, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. It lets me know that I should create more content like this. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell. And leave a comment. It's fun to read what you have to say. So with that, I hope you like this video. All the best for all your public speaking endeavors. And see you guys next time. Bye.